dusk of the final day. 8 hours remaining. Alright, well, chop chop. Time's a-wasting. We're about, maybe halfway through this? Maybe a little less. I'm concerned about the title a little bit. I don't think any of these rooms have really taken me 10 minutes. Maybe, the starter room. Well, it was a little bit faster than that. I don't know. I'd have to check the footage. I'm not entirely sure. I'm reminded, actually, that this is actually 10 minutes rooms rather than 10-minute rooms. And that, shuts off a potential, avenue of interpretation that I thought I was going to go with, which was 10, minute rooms. But, that doesn't really work here. If it's 10 minutes rooms, that's the only way you can read that. Alright, right, I set this aside. Okay, well, let's be invisible. Let's sneak around a little bit. Presumably, yeah, makes sense. We need to blow these up, but we're gonna do it with, kegs. But how will we do that? Get a caber. We can just bring that with us. I'm not gonna be able to take both of those with me. Okay. I think. Well, if you have a staff, then yeah, the time clone could go through here and, get that out of there. But I think I would cancel the recording if I became visible, so I guess the recording's gonna have to go in here and take this with it. Yeah, that makes sense. So the recording will go through here, it'll take the kegs with it, and it will be responsible for, bringing one keg with it. So I think it's gonna be responsible for blowing this up. Now we do have to test something real quick. Can eyes see past kegs? I can't tell right now because I'm invisible. Let's see, maybe we can test this out. Yeah, that shouldn't be too hard. We can test this out, like so. Okay, we're visible. Okay, and yes, as I thought, kegs kind of like mirrors in that they block the, line of sight, although they, do not reflect, of course. Makes sense. Okay, so I think what we're being asked to do is something like start recording first, take this with us. It has to be a caber. No other, weapon will go in here. Okay, I think I get it. So, we're gonna shove this over first. That's gonna go onto this square. Later on, you're gonna pick that keg up. Next, in order to kind of converge things into the way we want them, I'm gonna push this across like this. It's going to blow up, but that's fine. That's not gonna happen in the final timeline. In the final timeline, there's gonna be a keg here. So now we just have to pretend we have a keg. And that should be it. Like, I don't think I actually have to kill all these gel babies. That's a problem for future B-throw. That's a nice, phrase to say. I don't really... Oftentimes it actually is a problem that the time clone has to deal with, but I think I can actually just straight up get away with, this one. Alright. Seems fine. Oh, but I have a, stick, but that's okay. I don't think I'm gonna need anything else. Now, how am I going to kill all of these? Well, very carefully. We're going to do it like this. It's not fast, but it'll work. Okay, it feels like there was supposed to be one more trick to this room beyond what I did there, but it was pretty straightforward as far as this kind of thing goes. Just, blind manipulation of one object. I don't know, maybe I've been playing too many hard time clone rooms recently, or maybe I was spooked off by some of the other hard ones we even saw in this contest. But this one, not conceptually that difficult. Oops. Still possible to make tactical errors, of course, but things are pretty well under control here. In fact, I can even go back in here, but that doesn't get me anything. Okay, yeah, nothing to do out here. Just get those gel babies and shove them in the pit, too. Alright, that's all they wrote for that one. Okay, well, there's our, final destination. Okay, and we'll be coming in through here, so we'll go down this way. Alright, we'll just, we'll subscribe to the school of design that says we're just gonna shove this room into this corner. You know, the whole rest of this space don't need it, but we're gonna shove it up here. We're not gonna put it in the center, not gonna put it up in the upper center. No, we're gonna put it in the corner. That invites an unflattering comparison that I'm not going to make, but I'm still going to draw reference to for some reason. Now how this is gonna work, I'm gonna need a roach to go in one of these, and I'm also gonna need a roach to go in the other one, so, well, there you go. Okay, I think what I want here is to make it spawn right here, and I think this should cause a roach to make its way in there. Well, it certainly will if I do this. Alright, there we go. So that takes care of that. In fact, the queen is even nice enough to just stay right there because of the way I set this up, so I can just wait. Okay, that works. Alright, not that hard. Just had to be a little bit clever with the standard manipulation trick, really, and just hop to it. I don't think this was meant to be too hard. It's just a nice little diversion. Alright, and we've looped around to here. Guess we'll go ahead and take care of that south room while I'm thinking about it. Okay, so this will start a timer. Let's see what this plate does. It opens that, or, yeah, it'll open that when I get you back on there. But aren't you just gonna go right on the hot tile? Huh. But I can shove you off again. So you could do something like that, then something else needs to hold this down, but what would that be? A mirror? I mean, that seems reasonable. Oops. Not like that, though. Okay, so I get that on there, then we let the golems out, and we want to kill them as fast as possible, and then run in here, but wait a second. I need my sword back.
Exterminate.
Okay, I guess it's fine if a golem survives out here. Like, it's going to be safe from the blast radius, and as long as I can get my sword back, then I can take it with me. Sure. Okay. I mean, it's, I worked through that series of steps pretty quickly. I guess, honestly, I'm not really sure what to make of this. I guess I was expecting there to be more of a problem with the bombs blowing absolutely everything up, or there being exactly one safe place to stand for me and the golem, but it just didn't really work out that way. Like, it wasn't especially difficult to save the golem on the side there, and then just things worked themselves out. Yeah, so I'm not really sure what I guess the difficulty curve in this little level is just a little bit uneven, that's all. That's okay. These things happen. They happen to everybody. Alright, well, we're gonna need some help here. Help which we can obtain. Alright.
So my name is Bethro.
Yes, it is. We can reopen them like so, but does anything close them again? No. So, I guess what we're being asked to do is hold down this one specifically, get another one in there, it'll protect our back, we'll deal with all of that. Then we come back and do it again. Does anything turn this off? No. So we can keep one of them safe in there then, is what you're saying. Hypothetical architect. Yeah, I mean, we can... no, because of the way this works and this is being a force arrow, I can't shove, I couldn't shove a corpse across the force arrow line onto the hot tile, or flame trap, because I wouldn't get it back. Like, it would never revive. I can't shove it off of there again because I just can't access it without trapping myself on the Force Arrows. So we will need to keep one alive, but that's fine because that's more or less what we were trying to do anyway.
Exterminate.
We are going to need to get around this, though. So before we do this, let's put you in here. We'll kill it, and then this time we'll shove this on the plate again. We'll wait till it revives, but this time we can actually get around our second friend here, like so. Now we can go on our merry way to this end of the room. We have not much time, but... It actually might be better if it's over here. Yeah, this gives us more time and we can make a better escape. Okay. That's fine. We'll fix that later, but that's okay.
Exterminate.
Is this a situation we can get out of ourselves? Sort of. Probably not in a timely manner, so probably actually just better to shove you up here and take advantage of that.
Exterminate. Exterminate.
All right, that looks better. Yeah, that kind of pause, everything's dead, but now we just have a corpse that we could just shove into place. Okay. Little bit of a tactical challenge there, but not too bad. Just had to be a little bit efficient with my movement, but reasonable. As I suppose it would be if it's this close to the entrance. Wait, how do you get in there? So that's a conquer token, and you can just walk to it. Okay. I guess we might as well check that off the list. Excellent. Man, this is actually a pretty sizable looking hold. Is it symmetrical? If so, we're actually looking in... Yeah, there's gonna be more than 10 rooms here, so thus 10 applies to minutes rather than rooms. Because I think I've already spotted more than 10. Like, this is the 10th one, and that's going up, and these are all going out. So unless those three exits all go to empty rooms, which I'm sure they don't, then there's more than 10 rooms here. Alright. I mean, so far I've been enjoying this hold quite a bit. It's, you know, it's a little standard, but it's definitely using the second sky elements in ways that make things a little bit more complicated than they might look like at first. But even then, it's been like a nice exercise. Yeah, that's a good word. It's a nice exercise of those tactical abilities. So, I suppose... Well, the only things that can even go in here are rattlesnakes. Serpents don't go across Force Arrows, so... Yeah, that's... What closes this? Okay, so at the end of the day, we just want to kill everything, of course. Naturally. How are we actually going to get these rattlesnakes killed if I don't have a sword? Well, they have to wait in place and get their tails fried on the hot tiles. That's the only method I'm seeing of actually harming these things. So it would seem to imply that we want to thread them through this way. Because if I ever get a snake that goes in through here, it's going to stop here. Tail will fry here, but then the tail winds up here. It's going to wait right there. It's stuck. Nothing doing. So both of the rattlesnakes need to actually wind up out here. Probably one here and one here. We open the door. Oh, but that opens that. Oh. Darn. I guess that means the serpent has to act as an obstacle somehow, but... How's that going to work? Both of these move first, and that moves later. So, I guess that means it moves into position first, then the rattlesnakes do their thing. They die, and then the serpent goes through. I think the last thing that's going to happen... So we're going to wind up putting the serpent up here. It's actually going to have to follow us. We're going to have to hit this plate, like, just as it's going to here. So we're going to need to do a kind of a finagling thing where we send the serpent head up here. We're over here. We go in here. It goes horizontally into there. That will work. I hope that when the head is right here and these heads are here, that everything just kind of lines itself up magically. Well, I shouldn't say magically. Also, there's a bomb here that I've been completely ignoring. I have no idea what this fuse is for. Yeah, why is this here? If it's just gonna blow me up... I mean, I could... Well, I don't have a sword. If I did have a sword, I could blow it up, but... since I don't, it's just forbidding me to step here. But why would I want to step here? Why would a serpent want to go here? I don't know. It's probably just like a... I guess what it's doing is it's... Somehow that plays into keeping a rattlesnake from going across here, but... We could have just used tunnels or something. I'm not sure. I don't get it, but... Anyway, I've already outlined my plan, and then I just kind of stared, boggled vacantly, as the expression goes, for a couple more minutes beyond that, just because I thought it was amusing, but, let's actually just try and get this room done, shall we? Oops, well, the only way that rattlesnake's getting out of there is if we get there with, vertical preference, which I think this should do. Yep, there we go. Now, thankfully, making a snake go east isn't that hard. All you need to do is, make it so that it can't go north, and then kind of try and lure it the way you'd like to, and then, do the things that I've mentioned in some of my other snake charming videos. So, that's a classical way of doing it. Lead it south, then step north. It's still on vertical preference, so it wants to go north, but it can't, so it goes east. Then you step down again, you're behind its head, goes east as far as you want it to go. Alright. Now it's going that way. I don't think I wanted to shorten, though. I think I have to have it at maximum length, so let's operate under that assumption. I'm not really sure why the second invisibility potion is there, either. It's probably just a red herring. Luckily, the invisibility potion will actually let us line up the snake preference, too, in the way that we want it to. So I think we want... one unit of horizontal and then a bunch of vertical. So that way I can make it vertical again, and now it's horizontal. Now I've gotten there just in the nick of time. Okay, so as expected, that lines up well, and then this, and then everything is terrible. Oh, we could sneak out this way. Oh, that's what this is doing. Oh. Well, okay then. So actually we want, Yeah, so we want, two of these to... Wait, can I blow up both of them? No. No, I can't. Is there anywhere I can get a singleton like this to fry? I don't think so. I think that's been ruled out. What happens if I wait a little while? Well, then they come in here. Don't want that. Wait a minute, I'm invisible. Yeah, that'll work. I'm invisible. It's easy to forget when these snakes are chasing me, but I am invisible. And we can apply that. Like so. There we go. So once the snake stops seeing me, then it just waits in place. And, doesn't know what to do. Snakes don't know how hot tiles work. They have not been to college. Alright, there we go. Got tripped up there for just a moment, but just a moment, not too much. Alright, well, we might as well continue the theme of snakes and invisibility. Sure. We just did most of this. Hold on. Now what? I guess we want to go horizontally now? That'll give us enough time to sneak our way in here. Oh, but we don't want any of them to go east this time. If they wind up in there, that's just gonna be bad news for everyone. Okay, now I think we have things under control. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, we'll just steadily fry them and season to perfection. There we go. Okay, we're gonna have to engage with these a little bit, but thankfully not too much. Hold on. Okay, next step. How are we going to kill these? I think I know. We're gonna need, just one adder friend might be enough. It's gonna be a little bit finicky, but I think we can still make it happen. We seriously need some breathing room, though. I mean, maybe we can get extras here. That might help, but, there we go. Let's try and keep things simple if we can first. Okay. Yeah, first we'll just do this. You just get out of the way. Next, we send you north if possible. That is a little bit troublesome. Standing here is enough to move this along. Which is fine. We'll just send this that way instead. There we go. There, not too bad. Bit of a tactical fighting room this time, but with a little bit of a twist at the end. Alright, and our friend the Time Token returns. But, once again, as I've come back to and mentioned on prior occasions, there's only one Time Token. And we got a nice bit of symmetry here, too. Let's see how that comes into play. Well, I guess I would like these to fry themselves on the hot tiles, but how are we going to get that accomplished? What's this do? Okay, holds that down. Doesn't need to do that for real long. Oh, we're gonna need another construct to hold this down for a while, because we're gonna need this to come in here. Maybe we can get a golem to do that. Like, what happens if we standard room tactic. What happens if we take a golem from one part and we use it in a different part? I'm not even using the time token at this point. I'm just playing around. Well, our ability to manipulate this thing is obviously kind of limited, so we wind up in this kind of nonsense. But leaving that aside, that is a good question. How do we kill this thing? I mean, with time tokens working together in tandem, we could... Yeah, how's this gonna... How are you gonna use this spot? We'd like to drop this trapdoor, I guess. All we need to do, though, we don't need to kill everything on hot tiles. All we need to do is beeline towards this sword token if we possibly can, and then from there, cleaning up will be a snap. This is a question of getting there. Alright, we'll restart. How do these move? What kinds of stuff do they do? Okay. Presumably, we actually want to carve out a little tunnel, but no wait, I've already messed up. Like, that's no good. It's okay if we drop the trapdoors on the way in. Well, yeah, that's another thing. Like, if we set this part up properly, then you can go onto that plate and wait, as long as that doesn't mess everything up. Then you can kind of come in with a sword and clean things up later, because you'd break these crumbly walls. So if I can get you onto the plate, then things should be okay. It's just a question of, okay, so there's two of these, and there's exactly two of these trapdoors. Okay, makes sense. So you probably want to make this kind of a lure. But we want to do it in such a way that this goes north. Okay, that looked... Well, almost. Well, you can be distracted. If in the final timeline, Beethra goes in here and I have a time clone up here, then when I do this... If Beethra is right here, this construct would go up here, which would help, but That presupposes quite a lot. Okay, let's change tactics. I think maybe instead we want to take a look now. Maybe now instead we want to take a look at getting this part done. Okay, you need to get out of the way. Just go somewhere else. Shoo. Yeah, there. Now, you go over here. I guess you're gonna have to go like that, and I've already walled myself in, but not quite yet. Okay, then we go over here, then we over here. Okay, so this part is doable without time clone assistance. I can do all of that with just one B-throw. As long as we leave this somewhere where it's not going to be in the way, I don't interfere with whatever's going on down here. I can take some time out of my busy schedule to hang out down here for a little while, be a distraction, then move up here and wait for you to get to here and get my sword back. So this is going to be final B-throw who's doing all of this stuff. So what does a time clone do then? Well, the time clone can't rely on B-throw's help. That's the problem. And of course, a time clone is never going to witness final B-throw stepping on this plate. So it almost seems like there's a strict assignment of time clone down here and B-throw up here. It doesn't necessarily have to be that way, but the room is at least strongly suggesting that. I don't know how strongly it's going to enforce that, but we'll see. Alright, let's review. What does this look like? Yeah, there is fundamentally a problem of dodging around this thing, which it's hard for us to address with just the limited resources that we have. Yeah, I'd like to leave it behind here, but that implies that I have some kind of route out of there, and maybe I have enough distance on it that I can kind of duck around a corner and get around it, but even then, yeah, that's pretty iffy. There is another option. If I can somehow dispose of both of these constructs, or at least maybe just the first one, then Time Clone can wait on the plate and other B-throw can go wait on this plate. Yeah, somebody waits on this, then final B-throw would have to be the one that goes through there. Then final B-throw is holding this down, and regular B-throw goes through here. So that doesn't work, so let's rule that out. I mean, never mind the intervening steps. Like, logically, it's just not going to work. I don't know. These trapdoors are trickier than I gave them credit for to begin with. Yeah, they're just not gonna go anywhere else. Now, I can finagle something like this, but then I'm cutting off the only... No, it's not the only route I have. If this is held down, then I can sneak through. Okay, yeah, that's good to know about. Okay. Actually, I think that's the breakthrough I needed. Yeah, I like it. I like where this is going. Okay, then... Can we do it again? I don't think so. Alright, we need to go on a merry chase once again. I don't think you need to actually interact with this, but... How am I going to actually get all the way over to this east column? I need to in order to get you out of there. I don't have to go... Actually, I don't have to go real far. That's enough. I need to ditch this hanger-on, though. They're being a lot more of a problem than I gave him credit for. No, hold on. There's something I can do that's better than this. I don't need to wall this entirely in. The route I'm gonna take is gonna involve this construct going up here and into here. Then later I'm gonna come down here, lure this right in, and it'll hold down the plate. So for that to work, I don't need this to be dropped. I just need these two, which I've already done. So that part is fine. The problem is I need to take care of you and make you not be right behind me, because that's what's kind of leading to these problems. I'm just not sure how to make that work. I guess coming in from this angle is better. Is it, though? It might not be. Yeah, the fact that it's still kind of sidestepping me north is still proving to be a problem. Yeah, I just don't like the way that it's cutting me off like that. And the same thing is going to happen if I go the other way, because then it's going to sidestep west. And I just can't squeeze through here because of the way that this is set up. Darn, if I had that one square of separation, I could do a lot of things with this construct, but I just don't have it. Yeah, and that is also a problem. I can't just run for it and just book it immediately. Oh, hey, that worked. It's kind of by accident that I came across that, but I'll take it. Yeah, all I need to do is actually just run around this guy. I don't even have to go real far. Just something like this will do. No, it has to be better than that, because I have to be able to make a step south and then north, so I do need at least a little bit of separation. Okay, so we'll make a break like this. No, that's not good enough. Darn, we're close. I can feel it, but I need to make, like, a full runaround. Oh, that'll do. Okay. That's fine. Now we can go here. That's doing something or other off in the background. It'll be doing something different in the final timeline. I think I just don't care at the moment. We'll just sit here and wait. Now, your job is just to sit and wait out of the way. Try not to let anything happen to you. Oh, I have distracted you at a bad time. Okay, well, let's not do that then. We'll hide up here. Oh, this plan has not gone well. Okay, I need to hide down here is where I need to hide. Except that won't work, because I'm going to distract you at a bad time. Wow, this is a surprisingly complicated room, as it turns out. Where is it safe for me to stand? Okay, that's better. I think what happened is somehow by some miracle, I managed to not drop this trapdoor somehow, and I didn't realize anything was wrong. But now that I have, I can just safely hide down here, and we're okay. Okay, you are going to... Oh, you're... right, we need to actually get you trapped in here, don't we? And we need to dodge around the golems. Oh, I forgot about that part. Yeah, well, there's gonna be an angry golem, and, not much to do about it. Maybe it's gonna be your job to let the golems out. And do what, exactly? Can wait. Like, I don't need much of a head start, but I do need a little bit of a head start. They do definitely have to be well out of the way, and I have to be able to then get through here. Okay. Alright. See what I mean about difficulty? Like, there's only four enemies in here, but the intricacy of the trapdoors, the small amount of space I have to work with, and the large number of steps I have to go through all in one planning series has definitely made this room harder than, this one, for example. But that's okay. That's almost to be expected. Let's see. Let's just play this out. Let's just see what happens to this whole shebang. I want to play this out to the end and just see what happens. What did I have recorded for all of this? And, see from there. Yeah, as long as I don't get too close to you, you'll take care of that part. And somehow I need to take care of this part. Yeah, this is the part I've failed to take care of properly. Yeah, so if I just pretend that nothing is wrong, then we just get to the part where I just haven't taken care of this part. If I can get you to step on the plate and lure the golems partially towards you, maybe that creates a window for me to get in here. It's not much of one. We could, in principle, we could do that even before the room starts. Like, what does this look like? Like, we do this, we get this out of here, we could put it somewhere else. I don't know how we're going to kill it, but we could definitely put it somewhere else. Like, lure this all the way down here. And, it's still a problem, but it's not as huge of a problem as it used to be. Now, as long as we stay in this column, that is still going to be a problem on the way down. I still have to deal with this. Well, here's one way we can kill something. It's not a good way, but it is a way we can kill something. So, now, at this point, I could retreat out here, take my time clone, have the time clone step on this plate for a little while, get the opening, just get somebody in here, then repeat what I did down here, because I haven't blocked any of this stuff yet. The case where we'll start running into the problem is when we need to do the runaround to get this onto the other side of us without the sidestep, because I was relying upon a situation where I kind of had this dropping trapdoors behind it. And then I kind of made it sidestep again. So I think I need this to still be open, which is a shame, because I was pretty proud of how I managed to actually kill this thing. But I think I'm on the right track. I think this is the sort of thing that we're being asked to do. I just am not quite executing it quite perfectly yet. This could potentially work. It seems questionable, though. Go ahead and, try this. Alright.
Uh-huh.
So we'll wait here for a while. Presumably our friend is just gonna kind of follow behind us a little bit, so mostly the same thing should happen to this golem. Mostly. I could pin you over there and I could seal the passage behind me if I wanted to. So we wait there. Goal of this is to get main B-throw onto this arrow. So, we'll assume that that succeeded. In fact, we could maybe do a little bit better. Alright, in fact, we'll wait here. Yeah, we'll give main B-throw a chance to do their thing. Can I follow straight in behind? Will that work? Let me do a quick test. Okay, you stay right there. Wait exactly... Well, no, you don't even have to wait any turns. Go. Alright, what does this look like? Pretty... No, it's... I don't think it's gonna work. I'm trying to figure out some way of pinning, you there. And okay, that works. That does work. So then you come down here, and I'm free to do something else with this, which could be, could be this. That is an option. Yeah, so then in the real timeline, I would just wait here a long time. Eventually, the door would open, and I would get my sword back. I would also have the option of waiting down here a little while if I wanted to mess around with the targeting priorities of these guys, but hopefully I won't have to do that. We'll see, though. We'll keep that in mind. All things being equal, I would like you just to be out of the way, though. Okay, we're getting there, though. Where else can I put you? The most convenient spot I'd like to put you would probably be down here. But I'm not sure if I can actually get that to happen. Probably not with the way this is arranged, but I'll give it at least a fair try. Well, that's not gonna help matters at all. And getting it down here won't help. Over here helps a little bit, but not enough. And otherwise, I just don't have a clean angle at this anymore. Well, no, hold on. Hold on. That's not half bad, but it still means I can't really get past this on this side. Yeah, it's just still too inconvenient. We're close. I'm just tripping over some of the tactical details. I think the strategy is sound. I'm just wondering how we're going to execute this at this point. One more time, maybe? We'll go ahead and wait here. We should be able to lure you out of the way. We'll put you here for a little while. That should give enough time for you to sneak over there. Then we take you out and, well, then what? Or can I go to deal with the problem that we have a golem right here? I guess now that you're over here, we can start finagling with the golem again from the perspective of the time clone this time, so can do our song and dance again. And this time we can do the circle around that actually results in it dying right here. I could kill it here instead. Does that help? Did I need that square open in order to deal with the constructs? I'm not sure if I did. Let me check. Oh, I was definitely escaping up the top, wasn't I? Yeah, well, hold on. I can do this. That's potentially helpful. Circle around this. And then it's okay if that's behind me because I'm going here. I'm not holding that down for real long. But that is enough. I've now opened this. Nobody is holding this part down, though. It could be me again. Like, at this point, if I just run for it and then get over there, I can press the plate again if I need to. And that would let you escape. And I could just disappear at this point if I wanted to. Let's give this a try. That looks pretty good. I do like where that is going. I think you need to... Yeah, you need to just sneak down here. You weren't supposed to go up, you were supposed to go down. Okay, be out of the way, just kind of stay here for a while. In fact, you also still need to be... Is that a good idea? Yeah, that's still a good idea. You're gonna do some... Yeah, it's gonna have to always be really, short distance manipulation for this to work, but it does still work. The issue is I actually missed my chance to get on the door. I need to be on the door at this point. Okay. This is still working the same way it did before, though. Okay. We're gonna hang out up here. That's all working the same way. This should play out the same way because I'm all the way up here. Sure. That looks fine to me. Sword. Finally. Oh, you got your sword back, too. Oh, I forgot about that. That shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, it just happened to work out that way, but it's fine. And thankfully I had that last trapdoor there. Okay. Neat room. I like that a lot. It was tough, but it definitely fell to analysis. Like, you could see I'm making steady progress on that each time I try something. I get closer and closer to something that works. And I think it's relatively open-ended. I think there's multiple possible solutions to that in a good way. It's definitely a tactical challenge through and through. I mean, you have to mix some strategy into there, but you're open to changing your strategy as you discover new things from your tactics. And I like that. Like, that's that gives you the kind of... It's my solution. I made it. I came up with it. Hang on. So I need to... Okay, that plate needs to be pressed. I've only got my stick to defend me. Good old trusty stick. Oops. There we go. The non-reflective stick at that. Okay, that looks good. And that looks better. Okay. We'll just create a nice log jam and get everything off the plate and then back onto it. Okay. Okay, now how many of these do I actually need down here? It looks like I need Omplik. Omplik will be helpers. But I also need a Wraithwing to come in here and shield me. And for that, I also probably need a second one following me. So I guess I need all of them. Fine, I guess I won't commit indiscriminate murder. I'm only going to do highly discerning, highly discriminate... Let's not finish that sentence. Okay, you get in here. You also need to get in here. How am I going to make you guys behave and get both Omplik in there? Very carefully. That's how. Yeah, too bad this doesn't connect. That would make things much easier, but that's just not how it goes. Okay, so actually I didn't want to do that yet. Better if you come up this way, and then you if I can get them mostly in the same place, mostly looking the same direction, it works out a lot cleaner. Close, but no cigar. Man, again, it's these tight spaces. They're, you know, they're innocuous, but they're really tough sometimes. There's gotta be a better way than manipulating two Omplik at once, right? I mean, I can do it to a certain extent, especially with unlimited undo, but it is a real hassle. What are these even for? I don't know. Not yet. There's just not enough space to really lure them in and kind of pull them in behind me. I was trying to get them both over on this right side of the map, but there's barely any room to do that. You know, you've got this pressure plate they're not allowed to hit, you've got this area where you're not allowed to stand, and there's just barely enough room to get them even to these two squares, let alone the east wall. In theory, that would be what you would want to do, is get them over there, then pull them in. Because you can kind of get around them and then get in, but that's just hard to do. There's just not enough room to do it properly. And the Wraithwings aren't really being much help either. In theory, I could get one of them in. Like, if I get one in, then sneak around in here, I could get one to sidestep in. But the problem is, whatever one I already put in there... would come right here, and it would block the second one from sidestepping in. So this bridge doesn't go far enough. Yeah. Let me back up a little bit. Too far. Good thing I stepped on a checkpoint here. We can restore and then use Unlimited Undo to go even farther back. Hope is not lost. We can go to any point in the time stream we desire. As long as we have been there once, we can be there any number of times. Anyway, I'm sure you realize that the correct answer is to not get my sword back. I was so eager to do that, but no, we still have great things in store for this stick, and getting the room done is one of them. Okay, now life ought to be much easier. Alright, that's more like it. I mean, what do we even need a, well, we're gonna rearm, but... Oh, we still need to actually kill things, but that's what the fire traps are for. I should have guessed. And now I have. I did guess, in fact. We need that second Wraithwing in here, though. Alright, if I can get one of them to cross the Force Arrow, then life should be easier. But I just don't quite have that working out quite yet. If I can kind of separate their angles too, then that would also help. Yeah, now I think that ought to be enough. Yeah, I'm so close. Okay, there we go. Yeah, now you're, yeah. Okay, excellent. All right, both of you can just wait in the wings. Pun not intended, unfortunately. And we're gonna take one of you with us. Maybe. There has to be a better way. Oops. Yeah, there is a pretty severe problem with putting a Wraithwing on one side of me while the other one is behind me. And I think I can solve that by just shoving them both in there. Sure. They'll eventually want to go a different way. So let them. In fact, yeah, that's where they should go. I've got a stick. I might as well use it for something constructive. Nearly. We're close, but it's just not quite right. Yeah, actually, hold on. I need to break the orbs first and then get the Wraithwings on there, so just sticking them on the arrows is going to be good enough, because then the beams will be blocked and we're not going to break the orbs. So... one would work, though. Yeah, if I put one Wraithwing on there... no, that's not going to be good enough because it's going to run away from me. I, like, need the second one to come in later, at a delay, but the only way I could do that is if, I get a real good head start on the first one. But I could manage that, I think. If we back up to the part where, this happened. If we just get one of them across the Force Arrows, and then we just put the other one as far away as we possibly can. Like, over here. Is that enough to make you run away? No. No, because it's not actually that far away in practice. Where can I stash you that I can get you back later? I don't know. By some miracle, that happened to work itself out. I'm not sure what exactly happened there, but... I mean, as hilarious as this is, it's actually pretty surprising how close this is to working, but I'm not sure that's correct. Like, I think the parody's off if we're being honest here. But it's so, it is actually surprisingly close. Like, I need this Wraithwing to be one square ahead of the other one. And then we're there. But we just don't have a good way of actually doing that. Is that good enough? Yeah, just barely. Okay. And the fact that I had this Wraithwing back here was what, yeah, this Wraithwing right here is what is keeping this one from running away at the crucial moment. So while, I get here in the nick of time and, like, yeah, it's already there, so it's not in the corner, this Ultic Beam is blocked for the one turn that I need it to be. Okay, weird room with how it turned out, but I'm okay with that. It did wind up being not too bad. Bit of a shame that a stunned Ulmplik still sees you, but I guess stunning really only keeps something from moving, not from, Oh yeah, this is a fun trick, too. I'm right in between these two Wraithwings, but paradoxically, I'm actually too close to either one of them to want to attack me, so I'm safe. Okay, now that I've got some breathing room, now life is easy. Alright. Neat. That is not how I expected that room to go at all, but I'm happy it turned out the way it did. Alright, we're running up against the hour mark, so yeah, fine place to stop and take a break and collect ourselves. Next time, we'll more fun with time tokens. And perhaps some other friends, too.